Good morning, children. Let us begin with Standard 5, English Grammar, Unit 8, Pronouns, Kinds of Pronouns. What is a pronoun? A pronoun is a word used instead of a noun. For example, look at Sita. She is dancing. Leela and Bimla have come to see her. They are glad to see her dancing. She is also glad to see them. So here, any noun which is repeated in a sentence and we replace it with another word like she, her, they, them, it. So we say that those words are pronouns. So we are using them instead of a noun. Now there are five kinds of pronouns that we will be learning in this lesson. Now your first type is a personal pronoun, are also called because they stand for three persons. That is, first type of pronoun is personal pronoun. Why do we call them personal pronoun? Because they stand for three persons. The first person is the pronouns which refer to the person or persons speaking are called pronouns of the first person. If just now I am speaking, so I am in the first person because I am the speaker. So in this pronouns, which type of pronouns do we use in the first person? We use I, we, me, us, mine, and ours. So some are used in the singular, some are used in the plural. And in all these where I am involved, I count myself in us, I count myself in ours, I count myself in we. So we say that these all are in the first person. Now the pronouns which refer to the person or person spoken to are called pronouns of the second person. For example, if I am speaking to you all, so you will be the second person. I am the first person and I am talking to someone else. That will be the second person for me. So in these pronouns, what type of pronouns do we use? Thou, thee, you and yours. This thou and thee, we mostly use it in a poetic rhyming when we write poems. So all that means you and yours. You is for a singular also we can use sometimes for plural. And yours also, sometimes we use in singular and sometimes for plural. Now the pronouns which refer to the person or thing spoken of are called pronouns of the third person. If two persons are talking about someone else, means someone third, so we say that third person is in the third person pronoun. So in that, which type of pronouns do we write? We can use he, she, him, hers, they, them, theirs and it. So he, she, him, it, they can be used in the singular, and hers, they, them, theirs, we use it in the plural. So according to the sentence and according to the nouns, we can replace them with these personal pronouns, and depending we see whether it is in the first person, second person or the third person, and we can use all these pronouns to replace our nouns, whether they are in singular or plural. Let us do this first exercise where we have to fill in the blanks with suitable personal pronouns. So your first one will be, look at the house, how it burns. This it we can use sometimes for non-living things. So we are talking about the house, so we say it. Second, I am sorry if I have hurt you. Always with am will go I. So I am sorry if I have hurt you. The third one. Now girls, you must not get excited. Now girls we are talking about, which is in the plural, but still we use you in the second person. Fourth, the teacher told Mohan that he should obey him. So the teacher and Mohan. Teacher we are counting as a male teacher, so we write him, and Mohan is a boy. So we write he in place of Mohan. Being a boy, we use the pronoun he. Fifth one, I like Meera because I feel I can trust her. So I is in the first person and Meera is a girl. So in place of when we have to repeat Meera, we write her. So these all are the uses of personal pronoun. Second type is reflexive and emphasizing pronouns. They both are mostly same, but the use of it in the sentence is done differently. So which are these pronouns? They are myself, ourself, yourself, yourselves, himself, herself, itself, and themselves. So when we for reflexive pronouns, how do we use them? When these reflexive pronouns behave like objects of the verb. So for example, when you read this sentence, I blame myself for it. So here myself, we know it is a pronoun. Now what type of a pronoun is it? Is it a reflexive or emphasizing? Here in this sentence, blame is our verb and myself comes after the verb. So here myself will be a reflexive pronoun because it is the object of the verb. It comes after the verb. And I is the subject which comes before the verb. The second one, we often talk to ourselves. Now we know that ourselves is a pronoun. Now what type of a pronoun? Reflexive or emphasizing? Now in this sentence, talk is your verb. And now ourselves comes after talk, after the verb. So we can say it is a reflexive pronoun. Third one, you will hurt yourself. Will hurt is your verb and yourself comes after the verb. So we say it is a reflexive pronoun. The fourth one, you will enjoy yourselves, boys. So your will enjoy is your verb and yourself comes after the verb. So we say that it is a reflexive pronoun. Fifth one, he let himself be cheated. Again, let is your verb and cheated comes after the verb, which is the object. So we can say this is a reflexive pronoun. Sixth one, she put herself to trouble for nothing. Put is your verb and herself comes after the verb and it is a pronoun. But which type? Reflexive. Seventh, they always talk about themselves. So talk is your verb and themselves comes after the verb. So we can say it is the object of the verb and it is a reflexive pronoun. The eighth one, the dog has hurt itself. So here again, has hurt is your verb and itself comes after the verb. So we can say that this is a reflexive pronoun. So both emphasizing and reflexive are same. But when the pronoun it comes after the verb, we can say that it is a reflexive pronoun. Emphasizing pronouns are used with a noun or a pronoun for the sake of emphasis. As I is a pronoun, first person, and I am emphasizing on myself. I myself was there. So here myself will be an emphasizing pronoun. Second one, we ourselves serve the guests. Third, you must do it yourself. Fourth, boys, you yourselves wanted this. Fifth, he himself told me this. Sixth, she herself looked after my wants. Seventh, they themselves went there. Eighth, the town itself fell. So all these pronouns, myself, yourself, yourselves, himself, herself, themselves, itself, are same as reflexive. But here they are emphasizing more on the noun and the pronoun. And they both are together, mostly written together. So we can say that these pronouns are emphasizing pronouns. They are putting some force on the noun and the pronoun. So this is the way we can find the difference of both reflexive and an emphasizing pronoun. Exercise 2. Now we have to fill in the blank with reflexive or emphasizing pronoun.
Your first one. I wash myself when I get up in the morning. Second, the horse has hurt itself. Third, he himself went to see the prisoner. Fourth, she herself is to blame for it. Fifth, Rita, you will hurt yourself. Sixth, we often deceive ourselves. Seventh, the thieves hid themselves. Eighth, the boys helped themselves to the cakes. Ninth, Pinky dressed herself beautifully for the party. Tenth, you yourself wanted this. So in the first, second, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth and ninth, all these pronouns, they come after the verb, so we can say they are used in the reflexive form, reflexive pronoun. And third, fourth and the tenth one, they are emphasizing pronoun because they just come with the pronoun he, she and you. They are emphasizing on that pronoun, so they are used in the emphasizing way. Your third type is demonstrative pronouns. Now this, these, that and those are used to point out the object or objects for which they are used. This and these refer to things lying near at hand, and that and those refer to things lying at a distance. So these words like this, these, that and those, they point out and they show you a particular object or a person or an thing. So we say that they are pointing out, and these words are the demonstrative words, and we call them, here we call them demonstrative pronouns. Now this and these, this we use for singular and these we will use in the plural for the things which are very nearby to us. And that and those, that we will use in singular and those we will use in plural, which are lying at a distance, where we point out and show some distance, object or persons. For example, this is my pen. This is a verb. And this comes just before the verb. So here we say that it is used and it is a demonstrative pronoun. Second one, these are my books. Are is plural, books is plural. So the verb are is plural and these is used before the verb. So it is a demonstrative pronoun. Third one, that is my house. I am pointing out and it is at a distance I am showing. And again it is coming before the verb is. So that is a demonstrative pronoun. Those are your books. So are is a verb and those comes before the verb. So it is a demonstrative pronoun. Now your next type is the interrogative pronoun. Interrogative pronouns are used for asking questions. For example, the first one, who made that noise? Second, what is the matter? Third, which is your book? Fourth, whom do you want to see? Fifth, whose pen is this? So when we have to pick out an interrogative pronoun in the sentence, so we see that which words are asking questions, like who, which, whose, what and whom, we say that they will be the interrogative pronouns, and these interrogative pronouns also will come before the verb. So now let us do the third exercise. We have to fill in the blank with interrogative pronouns. The first one, who is the merchant here and who is the Jew? Second, whom did you give my message to? Third, which is your brother's bicycle? Fourth, what did you enjoy at the party? Fifth, by whom were you instructed in this matter? So all these we are using to ask questions and they come before the verb. So they are interrogative pronouns. The next type is relative pronouns, who,
whom, whose, which and that are used to join two sentences together, and they refer back to the noun going before them. For example, the first one, this is the man, he stole my purse. So there are two sentences and we need to join them with a relative pronoun. Which are the relative pronouns? Who, whom, whose, which and that. So we join it with who and make it into one whole complete sentence. This is the man who stole my purse. So now here who, it is doing two things. First of all, it is joining both the sentences and making it one. And this whom are we talking about? The man. So it is relating to that noun man. So these are the two things that what this word who does, and we say that it is a relative pronoun. The second one, this is the boy, his father is dead. Now we join these two sentences with whose. This is the boy whose father is dead. So here again whose does two things. First of all, it joins both the sentences, and we are talking about the boy in this sentence, so it is relating to that noun boy. The third one, this is the boy, the teacher praised him, and we join it with whom. This is the boy whom the teacher praised. So again, whom is doing two things, joining both the sentences, and we are talking about the boy in this, so it is relating to that noun boy. Fourth one, this is the house, Jack built it. So this is the house that Jack built. So that is joining both the sentences and it is talking about the noun house. The fifth one, this is the horse, it won the race. So this is the horse which won the race. So which is joining both the sentences and it is also talking about the noun horse. So here we can say that who, whose, whom, that and which are relative pronouns which join two sentences and says something more about the noun which is going before it. So as according to certain rules, who is used for persons only. It may refer to a singular or a plural noun. For example, the man who is honest is trusted. So here who we are using for a person, that is a man. The children who were there were frightened. So again we are using it for a person, that is children. They never fail who die in great cause. So here again who we are using about for they, which is a person. Whose is used in speaking of persons. For example, we met the woman whose child was hurt. So again, whose also we can use for about speaking about some person. When we two persons are talking about someone, so we can join it with a relative pronoun, whose. We met the sailors whose ship was wrecked. So we are talking about the sailors. So we join it about with whose. Whom is also used in speaking of persons. For example, this is the juggler whom we met yesterday. So whom we can also join when we are speaking about. So both can be used, sometimes whose and sometimes whom. These are the boys whom the headmaster praised. So here we are talking about a plural noun, that is boys. And in the first sentence we were talking about a singular noun, that was juggler. So in both the cases we can use whom, and sometimes we can use whose as a relative pronoun to join the sentences. Which is used for animals and things without life. For example, the cat which killed the rat belongs to her. These are the books which she bought yesterday. The moment which is lost forever. So sometimes we use which for animals and things. Certain things which are without life, means for books we can use which, and sometimes for animals also we use which to join the sentences. That is used for persons, animals or things. For example, the cat killed the rat that ate the corn. I have lost the watch that you gave me. The crowd that gathered there cheered him loudly. The wisest man that ever lived made mistakes. So here the relative pronoun that is sometimes used for persons, sometimes we can use for animals and sometimes things. So accordingly, we need to join both the sentences using these relative pronouns. Let us do the exercise 4. Fill in the blanks with suitable possessive adjectives and possessive pronouns. So what is possession? Anything that shows it belongs to someone. Both the adjectives and pronouns in the possessive form are same. But in adjectives, the possessive will come before the noun, and in pronouns the possession will be shown before the verb. So let us do this exercise. The first one, I have lost my pen. Can I have one of yours? So your pen is a noun and it is possession of mine is shown. So this will be a possessive adjective. Second one, Anil has lost his pen. Ask Maya if she can lend him hers. Third, we've had our breakfast. Have they had theirs? Fourth, you have forgotten to bring your book. You can have mine if you please. Fifth, they have lost their bicycle. They can use ours if they like. So all these my, his, your, yours, theirs are the possession forms. Some are in adjectives and some are pronouns. And remember, adjectives will always be used before a noun. Exercise 5, we need to underline the relative pronouns in the following sentences. The first one is being done for you. The first one, we like boys who are honest. So your relative pronoun is who. The second one, where is the pen which you brought yesterday? So which we need to underline. Third one, here is the book which you lost yesterday. So which is your relative pronoun. The fourth one, this is the house that my grandfather built. So that will be your relative pronoun. So children, before these relative pronouns who, what is written? Boys. And before which? Pen. Again before which? Book. And before that is house. So all these are nouns, and when we talk about the relative pronoun, then the noun which comes before that relative pronoun are called its antecedent. The fifth one, he was a great leader whom all people respected. So whom will be your relative pronoun and your antecedent? leader. Correct. Sixth one. Bring me the clothes which the dhobi washed. So which is your relative pronoun you need to underline, and clothes will be your antecedent. Seventh. This is the man whose son was killed in an accident. Whose is your relative pronoun, and man is the antecedent. Eighth. The answer which she gave is not right. Which is your relative pronoun which you underline, and answer will be your antecedent. Ninth. We met the sailors whose ship was wrecked in the storm. So whose is your relative pronoun you underline, and sailors is your antecedent. These all are nouns. The antecedents will always be a noun. Tenth one. The juggler whom we met yesterday will show some of his tricks. Whom is the relative pronoun you need to underline. Juggler is your antecedent. 11th. Show me the knife that you have bought. So that will be your relative pronoun, and knife is your antecedent. 12th. The boy whose parents are dead is called an orphan. So whose will be your relative pronoun, and boy will be your antecedent. 13. She has lost the watch that was presented to her. So that is your relative pronoun, and watch is your antecedent. 14th. He that is not with me is against me. So that is your relative pronoun, and he will be your antecedent. 15th. It is only donkeys that bray. That is your relative pronoun, and donkeys will be your antecedent. Exercise 6. Again, we need to fill in the blank with the relative pronoun in the following sentences. The first one. They never fail who die in a great cause. Second. God helps those who help themselves. Third. This is the juggler whom we met yesterday. Fourth, give me the letters that the postman left. Fifth, we love those persons who are kind to us. Sixth, time that is lost is never found again. Seventh, is this the road that leads to the station. 8th. These are the dogs that bit the children. 9th. The girl whom you see standing there is my sister. 10th. This is the man whose courage saved us. So all these are relative pronouns. The exercise 7, we need to join these sentences together by using only who. So sometimes we need to change the framing of the sentence and join it with who. The first one, the girl is reading a book. She is my sister. So you join it like, the girl who is reading a book is my sister. Second one. The boys were punished. They were lazy. So you join it like, the boys who were punished were lazy. Third, the thieves were caught. They had stolen the jewelry. So you join it with, the thieves who were caught had stolen the jewelry. Your fourth one, this is the doctor. He cured me of malaria. So you join it like this. This is the doctor who cured me of malaria. The fifth one. The child has been killed in an accident. He came here yesterday. So we join it like this. The child who has been killed in an accident came here yesterday. So when we are joining it with who, we need to change the framing of the sentence, but we keep the meaning of the sentence same. Exercise 8. Join each pair of sentences into one sentence using who, whose, whom, which, or that. So let us do this exercise. The first one. These are the men. They fought for their country's freedom. So your answer will be, these are the men who fought for their country's freedom. The second one, the thief stole the watch. The thief was caught. So your answer will be, the thief who stole the watch was caught. Third one, the pictures are very beautiful. They are on the wall. So your answer three will be, the pictures which are on the wall are very beautiful. The fourth one, here is the doctor. His medicines saved the child's life. Your answer will be, here is the doctor whose medicines saved the child's life. Fifth one, Ashok is an intelligent boy. All the teachers like him. Your answer, Ashok, who is an intelligent boy, is liked by all the teachers. The sixth one, the boy tells lies. He deserves to be punished. Your answer, the boy who tells lies deserves to be punished. The seventh one, the dog bit the burglar. He had broken into the house. Your seventh answer, the dog bit the burglar who had broken into the house. The eighth one, this is the juggler. His tricks amazed us. Your answer will be, this is the juggler whose tricks amazed us. Ninth, those mangoes were very sweet. You bought them. Your answer, those mangoes which you bought were very sweet. The tenth one, the boys clapped heartily. They were watching the match. Your answer will be, the boys who were watching the match clapped heartily. 11th, he is a rogue. Nobody trusts him. 11th answer, he is a rogue whom nobody trusts. 12th one, she bought some flowers. She gave them to her mother. Your answer 12 will be, she bought some flowers which she gave to her mother. 13th one, the beggar had a wooden leg. We saw him yesterday. So your answer will be, the beggar whom we saw yesterday had a wooden leg. 14th, this is the boy. His leg was broken in an accident. So your answer 14, this is the boy whose leg was broken in an accident. 15th, the captain praised Chauhan. Chauhan's bowling was very good. So your answer will be, the captain praised Chauhan, whose bowling was very good. Exercise 9, we need to fill in with there or it. So let us do this exercise. The first one, it is important that you understand the meaning of the word first. Second, this evening there will be a concert in the school. Third, is there any snacks left for one to eat? Fourth, it is too late to go shopping now. Fifth, what time is it? Sixth, there is a wonderful library near my house. Seventh, how many days are there in a week? Eighth, it is not necessary to work on Sunday. Ninth, there are 4 pens lying on the table. 10th, in Chennai, it rains during winter also. So dear children, I hope you have understood this lesson of pronouns. So now the homework for you is that you need to write the definition of pronoun and all the other exercises very neatly in your English grammar notebook. So thank you and have a very nice day.